was the night the All Blacks brought the house down at the stadium.
And another try coming up here for New Zealand. Alatidi. Sensational.
A night right up there with their most famous encounters.
Callum serving away, and Christian Cummins gets his second. Can they hold him up? The try's been awarded.
Against their other famous rival.
Kick ahead for Cullen. Christian Cullen!
Between the All Blacks and the Springboks, the clashes have been monumental.
Now for Stransky, the attempt to drop goal.
He's broken the deadlock.
And often decided by the slimmest of margins.
Here they go, under Best Tyson, what a pass!
The only clash that could rival the Bledisloe Cup in the land of the long white cloud. Tri Nations Game 2. New Zealand versus South Africa.
Yes, and here we are. This is Jade Stadium in Christchurch, South Island of New Zealand. It's a fine day. The temperature, quite a chilly 10 degrees, but the ground surface in superb condition, and this crowd building up to over 40,000 fans. There's a new southern stand. It's just been built and finished 2 days ago. There on the right-hand side, you can still see the construction cranes, but I think we're all still on a high after that extraordinary match at Stadium Australia last weekend. Can we see a repeat spectacle here? The Springboks are determined to throw the ball around. But let's have a look at the Tri Nations table. We've had one match so far, the game at Stadium Australia. New Zealand getting a bonus point for their five tries. Australia getting two bonus points. So that's a very good result for a losing team. And the All Blacks and the Springboks, these two great rugby nations. They've met 54 times in their history. It's 26-25 in favour of New Zealand with three draws. The South African team have been based at the five-star resort, the eco-tourism resort, Kooran Cove, just off the Gold Coast. They had 10 days there. They really focused on defence and also the lineouts, which was they see as a key area in this game against the All Blacks, who've been at Hamner Springs. It's a thermal resort, those lovely thermal pools that Chris Handy just simply adores after a hard game of rugby. But the All Blacks in pretty fine fettle, as are my co-commentators. And what about Jonah Longu? Sensational performance from him last week. Well, Simon Poitevin and Chris Handy join me now. Simon, the last time these two sides met was at the Millennium Stadium, the playoff, the third in the World Cup, and South Africa won. Can they do it again?
South Africans certainly win today. Psychologically, New Zealand have come off a huge game in Sydney. They got out of jail in the last few minutes. The South Africans have picked a very mobile side, a very aggressive forward pack out there, so they can cover out on the New Zealand back three. And thirdly, Nick Mal has been really whipping this side since the big loss in Melbourne, so they're very fired up.
Yes, and Chris Handy, everyone is still talking about that magnificent spectacle last week. A lot of changes to both sides, though, for this game.
Yeah, I think the problem is whether they've changed because they were disappointed with the performance or whether these are proactive moves to counter various strengths of the opposition. I think the proactive one's the way.
A white hot start here by New Zealand. If George Gregan hadn't tackled Jonah Lomu, they could have had four tries in the first 7 minutes. It was amazing stuff, Simon.
Yeah, in history we've always seen the New Zealand sides, if they start extremely well, it's very hard to get them back. And with the likes of Lomu, who was absolutely on fire last weekend in Sydney, he took so many Australian defenders out of play, and you see the gaps then open up for New Zealand. South Africa can't allow them the same latitude today.
And what about the comeback, Chris, from the Wallabies?
Yeah, that was stunning good, and I think they've shown that now Australian sides know how to win. And the All Black sides, was struggling at half time. They were under pressure.
Big Jim Williams, great sensational game. Performance at number eight.
In Melbourne as well, and in that game he backed it up, and that's really, a bonus for the Wallabies.
One area where the Springboks may struggle a bit today is in attack. The Australians in attack have got so many options out there. Rod McQueen has worked extremely well at getting across that flat line defence, and here he is, a big man who will really have to try and cover today. He hasn't scored a try against the Springboks.
Yes, he's met the Springboks seven times in test matches and failed to score a five-pointer. Now, this is Colonial Stadium 2 weeks ago. The South Africans led until the 68th minute, Chris Handy.
Yeah, they did, though, give Australia some options. There was six or seven clean line breaks. And I think that's why the change to the All Blacks team for today's game. I think they're looking for those opportunities that might come up and going to punish the box badly.
So here the All Black players coming out for a bit of a limber up on Jade Stadium. We'll be back with more of the build-up in a few moments. Well, it was Gold Rush at Stadium Australia last weekend. It's Blackout Day at Jade Stadium. Todd Blackadder's hometown of Rangiora has been officially renamed Blackadderville for this week only. But Jade Stadium is awash with a sea of black hats and jerseys and black faces, and it certainly is a splendid occasion. Let's set the scene over there at Jade Stadium now, and joining us is former champion New Zealand number 8, Murray Mexted. Well, Murray, I have Simon Poitevin and Chris Handy with me at the moment. I think only appropriate we show you a bit of footage of one of your great tries for the All Blacks. Poito packing into the scrum here, but he was on the other side.
Oh, he wasn't caught on the side of the scrum again, was he? Simon.
Murray, set the scene for us at Jade Stadium.
Well, of course, they're all a bit loopy down here in Canterbury, but it is a magnificent day. It's absolutely superb. The Port Hills, that's Port, not in Port you drink, but Port Hills, are absolutely clear, so it's going to be a lovely day throughout the match. But really, they think this is the biggest game of the year down here. I actually thought last week was, and you'll probably agree with me, but they just think this is the game. I mean, the whole of Canterbury is behind it, of course, and in fact the South Island, and they're calling it a blackout. All the flags are black, everybody's supposed to be wearing black, so it's a huge occasion for sure, and it's going to be a big event.
Murray, Buddha's eyes lit up when you mentioned Port, but what about the defence? Australia's defence early on last week was a bit of a shambles.
Well, I wouldn't call it a bit of a shambles. I'd have to pay credit to the attacking ability of the All Black side. I know you guys don't want to do that, but I mean, they have a lot of strike power out there, and really, I mean, how can you contain a side that has the ability to move the ball to players like Lomu and Cullen and Umanga?
Yeah, well, I guess the Australian wing is leaving their wing, coming infield. But what about the Springbok midfield against Australia at Colonial Stadium? Robbie Fleck has this tendency to really rush up.
So you've noticed that too, Gordon?
Well, have
I think
indeed.
That's actually pretty, yeah, that's pretty noticeable. It's interesting that they've brought in DeVette Barry to play with them, and of course he plays with them in the Stormers. So maybe that will help them, but he does run up quickly, and that's very dangerous when you've got the likes of Alatini who can step and move so well. Two new combinations in some respects at international level, especially with Robinson for New Zealand. A little bit of an unknown factor, I think.
Well, Mex, last week in Sydney, John Olomu was a huge influence on the game. Take him out of your attack, would you struggle?
Oh, I'll give us a break. I mean, that's pretty heavy, isn't it? Are you saying we're a one-man team, Simon?
Well, all I can say from Sydney, he did type a lot of our guys in defence.
I think if you took him out, we'd still have a lot of strike power, really, because I think Cullen is dynamic, and I'm sure you'll agree. And Umang is a handle for he's a handful for anyone because of his balance when he runs. He doesn't seem to lose any strength.
The changes to the All Black forward pack, do you think they're reactive or proactive, given the opportunities in the line-out or the problems with the All Black line-out? And what about Brayton Poulsen swapping over to the other wing? What do you think of that? Is that naive?
There's a lot of questions there, Chris, but I think it's proactive. Wayne Smith is very proactive, and I think he's continually thinking. The introduction of three new players is unusual for New Zealand, of course. We don't very often change winning All Black sides. Flavel, he's a big, strong, nuggety, powerful, aggressive forward, and I think it's good that he's getting a game against the Springboks. He'll roughen up a couple of them, and I think that's a good idea. I think Cromwell coming in was predictable because really he's the main man in that position. Yes, Brayden Poulsen I think is their only line breaker that I can see. So he's a danger, he's a threat. It's a matter of whether they get enough ball out wide to him.
Can they win the Springboks, Murray?
Well, if you look at tradition, over half the games that have ever been played between the two teams have been less than 8 points. And in fact, honours are shared between the two teams, 36 to New Zealand, 35 to South Africa. So every game is very, very tight. And in fact, on this ground, I think the differential's only been 7 points maximum on the 5 occasions I've played. So yes, they can win.
Okay, Murray, always a joy to hear your balanced comments.
Nice to be on screen.
Yes, Murray Mexted, and we're very close to kickoff now, but I would like to tell you that these two sides have made changes for this big match today, and let's check out the lineups for Tri Nations number two. Firstly, New Zealand, Carl Hoft, Anton Oliver, and Case Mews. A new second rower coming in to join Todd Blackadder, Big Troy Flavel from the Auckland Blues. Well, what about Todd Blackadder? This is his first home test at Christchurch. He had a magnificent match last night for the All Blacks. He was ever present on the field, and he was there when his players needed him. He was in the engine room, always in the vanguard. The back row for the All Blacks, Tane Randall, and Josh Cronfield coming in for Scott Robertson, and Ron Cribb, who had a stormer at number eight last week. Justin Marshall and Andrew Mertens are the very classy halves for New Zealand. A new centre pairing, Peter Alatini, is joined by Mark Robinson from the Canterbury Crusaders. And this guy is all class. He had his first season of Super 12. He made his test debut against the Scots here. He's a big step up. He's also a very good tackler and defender, as the Scots found out. And Jonah, Tana and Christian, this trio, has scored 83 test tries between them. What a performance. Wayne Smith can justifiably be very proud of his All Black team.
We're trying to develop a new style of play, which is different to how they've played the last few years, and that always takes a bit of time. It's not second nature yet, but everyone's bought into it, and that's been a positive thing, and we'll continue to work on that so that, you know, through the year, hopefully we'll get some good improvements.
South Africa's front row, Robbie Kempson, Charles Murray and Kobus Fisaki. And in the second row, Albert Vandenberg, the string bean, is joined by Andre Venter, who's moved from blindside flank. That will add a lot of mobility. Venter, one of the outstanding players in the international game. He just gives 150%, and he'll add a lot of mobility to that tight five. And the back row for South Africa is Erasmus Corne-Kricke, the captain of the Stormers, comes in at open side flanker. He's also a punishing defender, Andre Vos, the skipper. And the halfback pairing, Werner Swanepoel and Bram van Straten, comes in for Louis Kuhn at number 10. Van Straten playing for the Stormers. De Wet Barry, also from the Stormers, in for the injured Yapi Mulder. Robbie Fleck, who'll be looking for a much better game than he performed against Australia. Brayton Polsa, Tennis Delport, those two wings have swapped because of Jonah, and Percy Montgomery at the back. But little Brayton Polsa, he took his opportunities. He scored two tries against the Wallabies at Colonial Stadium. He opened the season with two tries against Canada, and he'll be a big focal point in attack for the Springboks tonight. And thankfully, he doesn't have to mark Jonah Lomu and concede 42 kilograms. There's the lineup. We'll be back with more from Jade Stadium in a few moments. Well, this is a typical test day in New Zealand. The All Blacks have played seven internationals here at Jade Stadium since 1990. They've won four and lost three, including that big win by the Wallabies in 1998. But the youngsters are here in force. There are nine members of the Canterbury Crusaders team in the starting lineup, or the squad of 22 in this All Black team here today. Well, certainly this guy was the face of the World Cup in 1995 in South Africa. He didn't play any sport at all until he was 18 years of age. He's a national hero today. I refer to Chester Williams. He was the face of the 1995 World Cup in South Africa. And his president was the saintly icon who seized the moment for the Rainbow Nation.
Chester Williams, a hat-trick coming up.
To see him on the field, I mean, with that jersey, it just motivated me and I think the whole team to lift us ourselves up with another two or three levels.
Immediately after the final whistle, who can forget the sight of the Springbok team stooped in prayer? It was Chester who answered his skipper's calling.
Franz asked me, and obviously we always do it in the change room, we just decided we must do it on the field because it was such a great moment. And we just had to prove to the world that that's why we won the World Cup, because of our faith in our Creator.
Earlier in the tournament, our hero had recovered from injury to make a smashing cup debut against Manu Samoa.
Try! Cheeky Chester, the quadrilla, scores his fourth.
At that point of time, I didn't even know that was a South African record. They told me in the change room, and I realized, and I was so glad. I mean, it just tells how focused I was during that game.
Along with Brayton Polsa and Dion Kayser, Chester carries the flame for emerging black and coloured rugby players in South Africa. Some of this class of 95 are now young men starring in the national junior team.
We still need to progress into that, in the South African system where we still have to prove people that we can play rugby well in South Africa. And it's not only myself, I think Brayton is there now, Dion Kayser is there. So the three of us, we must just work hard and be positive that we'll carry the flag for our people back home.
Naming a test match in honour of Nelson Mandela had very special significance for Chester Williams. For it was the ex-president who showed the way forward for all South Africans.
I think it's unity and forgiveness. Nelson Mandela, I think he never kept that 27 years that he was in jail against other people. He came out and he was just like a great human being, friendly to everybody, forgive everyone, and that's what our people must learn from him.
Yes, and what a thrill to have the Nelson Mandela Challenge. Overall, these two great rugby nations have played 54 times. One win separates them, and only a matter of 20 or 30 points. And the matches, we've had three drawn. And in New Zealand, it's been very much for the All Blacks. They've won 15, and South Africa, 7. Well, what a scene it is here at Jade Stadium. Simon Poitevin and Chris Handy with me. Simon, the key to the outcome in this game.
Well, the defence is fine from the Springboks. Their attack is where they're a bit limited. And I do think that core of Canterbury players in this All Blacks side will drive them to win a victory in the finish. I think South Africa did very well early on.
And Chris, you have a leaning towards South Africa here. Why?
I do. Physically and mentally, I think the Blacks could be on that bit of a downer. And I think if the Springboks can expose that line out and also the defensive problems, I think there's a big chance for them.
Okay, well, the All Blacks are unbackable with the bookmakers. So we're getting very close to kick-off time. That's Tony Brown, who came on in the closing stages at Stadium Australia. And he's a guy who'll be certainly in the fray in the second half. Andrew Merton's found wanting in defence. There's Just van der Vesthuizen, the record holder for test matches for the Springboks. And Lovis Gutney there, who's been flown over to join the team. And Warren Brosnahan, who had a season with the Perth Reds in rugby league back in 1996. Nick Mallett there, who's the longest serving South African coach since readmission in 1992. So it is a wonderful atmosphere at Jade Stadium. Alongside me, Simon Poitevin and Chris Handy.
Well, this should be an exceptional game of rugby. The one question mark is how Chris White, the English referee, handles the game. Andre Watson did an outstanding job in Sydney, Australia, New Zealand, but the crowd here hyped up for what could be a gigantic game.
Yeah, remember the Wallabies' great win here at Jade Stadium, and it's a place where honours are shared. Everything's possible for the Springboks, and if they could pull off this win against the All Blacks today, doesn't that set the Tri Nations up superbly? Particularly for the return match with the Wallabies next weekend.
Well, New Zealand's 39 points last week against Australia has taken them over 2,000 against the Wallabies, so they're the first nation to register 2,000 points against any given country. So the box will come out in their tracksuit. Tops, Andre Voss. This young man is joined by Corne Cricker, who was a great leader in his own right, led the New Zealand under-21s, and Cricket coming in at open side flank. Hovis Vasaki, Charles Murray, members of the tight five for South Africa, but it's a pretty daunting sight, isn't it, for the Springboks as they come out at Jade Stadium. It is indeed a blackout.
It looks like a whole group of fruit bats, doesn't it? Flying foxes hanging on the out of the branches of trees with those black posters up.
So let's check out this South African lineup. It's the same front row
Andre Fenter, significant move into join Albert Vandenberg, and Corne Cricker comes in at open side flank, and in the backs, a new fly half in Bram van Straten, and Devet Barry is the new inside centre, and the wingers have swapped Delport and Polsa, so Delport will be marking Jonah. So we're still awaiting our home team, and Andre Fenter sent off against New Zealand back in 1997.
Well, it was a masterstroke bringing Andre Fenter into the second row against the All Blacks. He is a really good line-out jumper, adds a lot of mobility to that back five.
The All Blacks are dictating their arrival here on Jade Stadium.
Looks like canned heat, doesn't it? The door about to open. Look at this crowd waiting to welcome a victorious All Black team back to New Zealand. They've waited for them to strike that blow as they did last Saturday night.
Chris, you're almost expecting Jonah to burst straight through the door, aren't you?
Yeah. It's a great focus and a great part of the game at the moment. There they are.
They're all the reserves out on the field.
Craig Dowd, if he comes on today, he'll become the most capped front rower in New Zealand history. Blackadder leads him out.
The Knight of the Realm, the Canterbury Crusaders skipper. Three Super 12 championships. This is home territory for the captain and the vice-captain, Justin Marshall. And a deafening reception for the All Blacks. Todd Blackadder turned up for his first game of rugby when he was 6 years old. His mother took him, and he was turned away by the coach because he said he was too young. He left in tears, but slept in his gear that night. Troy Flamel comes in at number five to join Blackadder, and Josh Cronfeld is reinstated at open side flanker. In the backs, Mark Robinson is the new outside centre, replacing Iremia. Wayne Smith, former All Black who played against Simon Poitevin and Chris Handy in the 1980 Bledisloe Cup Series. I wonder if 12 or 15 years' time, one of those young boys from the Cathedral Grammar School will be out on Jade Stadium in an all-black jumper. Well, that's the longest New Zealand anthem we've ever had at a test match. Do you get the feeling this is a bit of an ambush, Chris Handy?
Oh, gee, that was, it looked like some of the players were sort of thinking, come on, bring it on, and so they should. If they're going to fire up like they did against the Wallabies last Saturday night, they need to be getting into it.
Well, there's Josh doing his familiar contortion, Simon.
Well, he made a huge difference when he came on in the game last week in Sydney, really disrupted the breakdown. Fabulous player. Tane Randell, probably his best game ever for the All Blacks last weekend.
Yeah, just an amazing work rate from Tane Randell last week. And the Springboks are going to move up to the front line here for the haka. Electric. Blackadder's men. And Case Muse. A Maori himself. The haka first performed by the All Blacks in 1905-6 on their tour of Britain. Now Chris White from England is the referee. He's an identical twin. Former player with Cheltenham. He had the World Cup opener between Argentina and Wales. He's just counting the players on both sides to see there's no more than 15, so he must have been a maths teacher, Chris.
It's a good sign when the referee starts counting right at the stop. Hopefully we're not counting the number of penalties he hands out. Nice, easy attitude towards it. Let it breathe, ref.
Tri Nations match 2000, Jade Stadium, Christchurch. Brayton Paulser. And this is Erasmus. Taken a little high there by Anton Oliver. Percy Montgomery. Big purchase on that kick. It's a huge one. 10 from halfway. Christian Cullen. Oh, that's a huge tackle by Cricker. He goes Paulser. What a start. He was taken late after he kicked it. It's a... Did he get it down?
He's going to be very close. Christian Cullen, Corne Cricker. He smashed him.
He absolutely pulverized him.
I think it's World Championship Wrestling. It was the full body throw. Slam dunk. There's no way that this try's been scored. The referee's looking at it. Justin Marshall gets a hand in front of it and pushes it away. Great scramble.
But certainly Paulser was tackled late after he kicked the ball. They're not going to get the penalty.
Well, that'd be very interesting whether the referee consider that, because certainly Paulser, watch him breaking away, and Flavelle almost gets him and hit late by Cribb.
He didn't have to follow through with that. You've got to say that Paulser had clearly got rid of the ball. He wasn't in the action of making the tackle. Marshall did so well to scramble.
Well, I don't think I've seen a tackle like that to open a test match, and certainly Cullen hasn't felt one like that. He was thrown down like a rag doll. And it all came from a huge punt by Montgomery. This is Cripp. Mertens. Kicking wide. Lomu's through. Delport. So good tactic there by the All Blacks.
Well, that wasn't very good tactics by Delport to allow that ball to bounce. As we see Mertens, this is his home ground. He knows the ground so well. Wallmer was on the chase.
And Leon McDonald's out there in 16 jersey wide, covering for Cullen. But they said they weren't going to kick the ball away, the Blacks, early, but clearly trying to get Lomu into the play.
New Zealand still in possession. The box have touched it twice, and it's been deep in their territory. They kick downfield. This is Blackadder. They were too slow, and he ran into a player in front, says referee Chris White.
A superb line-out jump there by Tane Randell. For me, the best jumper in the All Black pack. Oliver got his throw right, but Blackadder took a man with him through for shielding. Look at the difference there in pack weights.
Well, there's pressure on the South African scrum immediately. This is a lightweight second row pairing, Chris.
It is. They've been criticised, the Springboks, for not having the grunt of former packs. Their slider up front, they don't have that power in behind. Fenders in there to try and shore it up, but will it be enough?
That's a better low scrum. It's good concentration from the Bok 8. Ram van Straten. This is Leon McDonald on for Cullen, who looks to be concussed. He's a munga. He got away from the vet Barry. That familiar step off his right foot. Mertens. Justin Marshall standing out wide as he did at Stadium Australia. Level cleared it to Alatini and Blackadder. Crowd roars as Todd touches the ball.
No.
Very willing defence early on.
Get away,
Alatini. South Africa moving up, getting on the front foot in defence. That's Oliver. That's the halfway line. No score in the game. The Bok almost getting a sensational try. Cronfeld couldn't hold on. Kovas Fasaki pouncing. Erasmus. Devet Barry, a strong young man. Swanepoel. Bram van Straten.
Stay back.
The Bok playing with confidence here. There's self-belief. You can see it. Pulsar.
He's done it.
Robbie Kempson arrives. Swanepoel. Man taken without the ball.
He hasn't got it.
Andre Fenter was taken out there.
It was two, it was one early as well.
Nice probing attack there by the Springboks. They're using the small men. The halfback Swanepoel. Also, Brayton Tulsa to try and slip through this All Black defence.
I think that was the most intriguing thing, Simon, as you pointed out. It was Montgomery, then Tulsa, then Swanepoel.
No score. 6th minute. So can Christian Cullen resume here? He's been replaced and doesn't appear to be any blood. But it was a horrendous shud. You could feel the ground tremble as he was thumped by Cricker.
I think if you looked into his eyes, you'd see some very bloodshot eyes.
So can the Bok convert some of their early pressure here? Vital kick for Van Straten. Yeah, it's a beautiful strike. And that's reward for South Africa's fiery, spirited start to this game. 3-0.
Well, Andrew Merton's really mixing his game up here, Christchurch. A couple of strategic kicks out there, but also that inside ball using the big men, trying to batter their way through.
Well, just being able to stand in the tackle too and not go to ground, making a difference that time. Now that looks as though Brosnahan's on the field as well. So there's an injury in the Springbok side. And good play by Devet Barry. Erasmus, Swanepoel. Kovas Fasaki. Erasmus and everything. Tulsa.
That's gone forward there, lads. That one's gone forward.
It was definitely a forward pass going back in time before that one was picked up. The kickoffs to the Australian side last weekend in Sydney were an absolute nightmare, but this time the Springboks secure their ball. Vital.
This is Cripp. Going straight across field. There's a penalty offence coming for New Zealand. Tackler left his feet. Mertens now. Lomu. Cullen. A gift bounce, much as we saw at Stadium Australia. So he's recovered all right.
Percy Montgomery has dogged it. He came flying across in cover, saw Lomu and Cullen, had a peek and left it alone. I'm just flabbergasted.
Well, El Matador.
Referee's doing a very good job here, playing excellent advantage. What about the kick? And Montgomery, a right footer, he saw the big Mack truck coming up there and just blacked out.
It was as if he overran it on purpose. He came flying across. And Cullen, welcome back. Two touches, two sensational parts of the game. One flat in his face, the other a try.
Well, they're exploiting the inexperience of Tinnis Delport, who's a fullback. Twice they'd kicked in behind him. And second time it's resulted in a try for that man, Christian Cullen. And what a try-scoring machine he is. That is his 36th try in 46 test matches.
And what a recovery for Cullen from that smash by Corne Cricker.
Well, that one better off at the shooting gallery. So 5-3, 2 points in it. Cullen still taking some deep breaths after being almost knocked senseless.
Terrible kick here by Mertz. It's interesting this game so far. The All Blacks, when they had the ball in attack, are looking very constructive. Springboks still at sea.
It's a good kick by Van Straten. Andre Vos. This is Fleck.
Get away, Black! Get away! Get away, 30!
Swanepoel goes in. Montgomery's in to fly half.
Get away, Black!
Going nowhere. Swanepoel looks to the right here. Inside ball again. It's been a feature so far. Devet Barry very involved. Swanepoel. Montgomery. Pulsa. And this is Erasmus. Devet Barry. This is great support play from South Africa, but then pushing the pass. They didn't need to do that. They have to be patient.
Well, that was a totally unnecessary pass by Kabas Fasaka.
I think a little bit like the Wallabies did against Springboks. They made the break and then pushed the last pass. They just need to be able to settle. Fasaki came in, felt he could get it wide, but he was really pushing it. Take it up, settle it down.
There's a huge scrum there from the box.
From the first one, it didn't look like it was going to be that way. Looked like the All Blacks had their measure. This will be a lot more stable.
Well, just lack of concentration there from the All Blacks. The Mines are on the job here. Tana Umanga chases the Marshall kick. Brayton Paulser back here. This is Montgomery.
He's onside. He's
didn't
onside.
Have a lot of option there.
Okay, you're out of the way.
Montgomery.
There it is.
South Africa have pinched it. Erasmus. Van Straten. Fleck. Well, why did they kick it?
Well, you see Fleck trying to exploit Lomu there with the grubber through. The Australians have done it very well the last couple of years, and clearly the Springboks have watched them with success. Montgomery does really well here with concentration to pick up that ball from that All Black melee.
7 Black.
Well, the idea was to kick it behind Lomu. The All Black defence had just shadowed up, drifting. So Corne Cricker back on. I think he was hurt as well after effecting that initial tackle on Cullen. Brosnahan back off the field. Fenter. Van Straten. That's poor execution by the box. They could be punished here. Blackadder.
Get away, Green, get away.
South Africa really spoiling themselves in a good attacking situation. Mertens. Towering kick downfield.
Isn't it amazing? Wayne Smith had sort of indicated they wouldn't be kicking the ball much, not giving away the ball as they did a few times at Stadium Australia. But when the opportunities arise, Mertens has that ability to really turn you around.
Van Straten goes deep, down to the 22 here. Umanga. Cullen. Barry wraps him up and drives him back.
Here it comes.
8 from halfway. Mertens. Wild pass. So, a few nerves there. Nearly 13 gone.
Todd Blackadder hungry for a run out wide. Hometown hero here in Canterbury. It was a long time coming, the All Black captaincy for the Canterbury boy.
Thank you.
So Andre Venter, 49th test match today. It's his first test starting at lock. Vandenberg got it. Charles Murray. Andre Foss. Crib up very quickly. Into a bit of space here. Again, a push pass. Tulsa, Montgomery. Referee happy to play on. Montgomery does well to halfway.
No.
Just the composure needed from the South Africans. They've had New Zealand under a bit of pressure when they've maintained possession. Foss. Just making five. They're on the halfway line. Ram van Straten did well. The referee said he didn't release it.
He's on his feet, there's no support.
Very clearly there, Van Straten went through, no support, and Josh Kronfeld just lurking around in straight away. You watch him, goes to the ground, there he is. Kronfeld forces the issue, referee has no choice but to penalise.
Quite impressed so far with English referee Chris White. He's just right on top of the game, seems very comfortable.
So really, Van Straten there needed the support of his back row. They were just a fraction late arriving. 5-3 to New Zealand, one try to nil. Flavel got it nicely. Elatini. Lomu now. Crowd getting very excited. Case Muse came in. Blackadder at scrum half. Becomes Umanga. No one wanted it on the full. Vandenberg couldn't pick up. Justin Marshall sets it up for Randall. Mertens calls. Cripp. Solid defence from Van Straten. Case Muse cleared it. Jonah's out here and so is Cullen, 3 seconds. Unrelenting build up there from the All Blacks. They hit double figures.
Well, the Springboks here paying a heavy price, not using the ball, and actually making a difference against the All Blacks. The All Blacks getting a sniff. Every time they've got down here, they've really punished, and Christian Callan just cruises in again. Excellent play by Mertens to set this up.
Unless the Springboks are able to slow down the ball coming from the ruck and ball, they're going to be chasing leather all day. This just typical of that quick ball movement. The prop started it, gets pushed very wide, and there's just no one at home.
Burton's effectively using Lomu as a decoy there, just sends it wide to Cullen, and just no Springbok defence round.
So Cullen gets his second try. That's the third time he scored a brace of tries against the Springboks. And it's pushed wide, so still 7 points the difference. So Christian Cullen, man of the moment. Didn't look that way at the start. Good work there by Flavel again. So he's really getting a nice purchase on the ball when it's in the air with two hands.
No.
Josh Kronfeld mauling away there, just short of halfway.
Here comes Blackpool. See ya.
Back to Cullen. Ripped away by Flavel. Van Straten in defence. Oliver arrives with Randall. This is Alatini. Now we're ready for that step. Wrapped up by Fenta. They'll try and hold him up now. It could be a turnover. That's the strength of Andre Fenta.
It's not going to come from there. Thank you very much. No.
This is part of slowing the ball down. Just being able to tie it up and getting the turnover. It's very effective if you can do it. Not often you can do it against the Blacks.
Well, the Springboks really have to, as Simon said, treasure possession. They haven't been able to put any phase play together at all. And the All Blacks have taken advantage of their scoring opportunities.
Yeah, Mertens has had 13 possessions out there. He's passed on 9 occasions. Van Straten's had 12, and he's really mixed it up.
Fantastic pass there by Mertens. Really orchestrated some excellent plays last week in Sydney.
I went in next time. You got a hand on the far side there.
Punts right in there. The vet Barry. So he loses it.
Okay, we've got two there.
First time.
We've got two. We'll take the first one. Scrum down, Blacks.
And again, that's suicidal and from South Africa's point of view.
That's it, all right. Crouch and hold, gentlemen. No second rows.
Another interesting scrum situation. All Blacks feed. See if the Springboks can put a dent in it.
One try to nil when they last met at Cardiff last year, the playoff for third. All Blacks unable to score a try against the box. They have two here already, Jonah Lomu and Delport stuck with him. Well, that's something Australia wasn't able to do, put Jonah into touch.
George Gregan tried very hard. He's got a bit of a weight handicap though.
He sure didn't have a lot of room here though, but Delport missed Justin Marshall earlier. So it just holds on.
Albert Vandenberg. This is Erasmus. Used effectively as a runner. To Vet Barry. Halfway line centre field. Montgomery shows the ball. Andre Voss. Great work from him. Pisaki now. Now there's an overlap for South Africa. Cricker up the centre. Promising build-up from the box. Can they hold on to it? Van Straten.
It's coming, it's
Brayton
coming.
Are going in. Montgomery into first receiver again. Loose pass. Vandenberg. South Africa still has it.
Well done, Cornell.
Robbie Fleck.
You've seen what's happened, lads. Okay, calm down.
Well, that is pedantic refereeing, really. He accidentally ran into his own man, but it didn't affect the defenders.
Yeah, people got to understand the evolution going on in Springbok rugby. They have been a side that has really played a more defensive sort of game. They are now trying to play an expansive game. And they're getting through about 10 phases and thinking, what do we do now? We're not used to this.
Well, very few kicks from the box.
Cronfeld. Cricker again. The heavy defender. Payne Randall. 12 from halfway. Two tries to New Zealand, a penalty goal to Bram van Straten. Once the All Blacks hold on to it for more than three or four phases,
Mark Robinson's been cut out effectively. So far, they should involve him more.
Flavel. Forward pass.
Unlucky.
Oh, that was blown. Troy Flavel just burst through.
One of Flavel's real strengths is his explosive speed. Watch him go. Really aggressive runner. Turnovers quite high for New Zealand, running at 7-5 for South Africa.
Brayton Pulse are doing a lot of cleaning up in the game so far at the back.
Six green. Story is making the bind on far side. He's coming towards me. Next time, think about it. Get out of the way.
So I think it was Rassi Erasmus who missed that tackle on Troy Flavel as the big fellow strode through. And with Heineken Meyer and also Alan Solomons, his coaching staff. Springboks need some points. They're trailing 10-3. But New Zealand's had most of the possession. Tulsa.
No, get out of the way. No. There's no one in the way.
Erasmus to Swanepoel. There's a gap. Robbie Kempson. Fenter.
Get out of the way. Here it comes.
Going straight up the middle. Erasmus. Taken by Alatini. Ron Cribb. Don't argue tackle. Go straight ahead, said Andre Fenter. Take it up to Robbie Fleck. Fenter goes into Morlitz. Can South Africa slip it back here?
Let it go.
Couple of punches thrown.
There it comes,
Tennis Delport.
There it is.
Good tackle by Cribb in close, and a big clean out from the box. Devette Barry.
Here it comes. Stay there.
So the phase is now coming for South Africa as Delport comes in again. They're slowly making ground.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
Oh, big tackle on Bram van Straten. Here's Jonah. Had to release. He got to his feet. Expert control by New Zealand, but Marshall didn't do well. There's a little knock on by Randall.
He was not slow to ball that.
Rassi Erasmus, he'll get a job at any rate day around the country. It's the way to beat the big Jonah down.
There's been some indecision in that Springbok attack.
Yeah, it's not four. Right.
So there's the score, 10-3, two tries to nil.
Right. Okay, they're just bashing into each other in the middle, aren't they?
Got bogged down there. Good work by Vandenberg.
Well, that was a Ray Price Cumberland throw special.
Alfie Langer would be proud of that one.
Is he okay?
Now, the All Blacks have got some work to do. He's got to pull his team in. Todd Blackadder is the man to do it. Some opportunities for both teams.
Okay, boys.
Either side committing to that breakdown, and the pick and drive is on to get him behind first up.
We're 25 minutes into the game, only three penalties.
Bram van Straten now. He loops. Tennis Delport inside the quarter. That was a better structured move from South Africa. Andre Venter, who was down for attention just briefly. Robbie Fleck. South Africa, before the injury, held up the 10 phases, and Percy Montgomery has kicked a drop goal. He did it twice in the playoff at Millennium Stadium against the All Blacks. And South Africa finally gets a reward for all of that pressure. 10 play 6.
I think this is pretty appropriate for South Africa. Although they had the ball, they weren't looking like penetrating. They're fairly obvious with their moves in the backs. And it was important to get some points on the board and get it ticking over. Look at that huge black jersey, Daunting, hanging over there like a big storm cloud.
There's Kempson, who plays with the Stormers in Super 12. Erasmus, Bram van Straten on the angle, flipped it back beautifully. Montgomery and Pulsar. Kempson again. Good continuity here from the box. Andre Voss couldn't hold on. Wasted. Umanga. South Africa all offside. New Zealand spread it wide. Anton Oliver gives the defence a chance to regroup. Anton Oliver.
Get away, Green!
Some tired South Africans out there at the moment. Not a great kick. Jonah knocked on. There's definitely a knock on there by Jonah Lomu.
Back we come, back we come. His ball, I couldn't see.
Well, again, he's helped out by the touch-ups there,
11.
But it's good referee. He is allowing excellent advantage for both these sides, willing to run the ball.
You can hear the referee panting. I'm sure he wouldn't be used to the pace of the game. The ball's being moved around.
So Bram van Straten, South Africans taking some heart.
Okay, that's good, that's good.
That drop goal has just brought them back in contact. And they're the ones who've had all the ball over the last 6 or 7 minutes. Andre Venter. Good offload to Erasmus.
There it comes, there it comes.
New Zealand just can't get their hands on the ball at the moment. Devette Barry. Kobus Fisaki, tackled by Marshall.
Okay, there it comes.
Van Straten. Good tackle by Flavel. Josh Kronfeld waited for the crumbs.
Come back.
South Africa just didn't have the numbers at that breakdown.
Attack.
Knock on by Mertens. He took his eye off the ball and had a sneak look at the defence.
See what's happened, gentlemen. You can see what's happened.
Some enormous body contact going on at the breakdown here, both sides in the clean out. On that occasion, Lomu cleaned out, but he came back just as hard. Watch him.
Well, South Africa are just pressuring the ball carrier very well, forcing this error from Mertens, and they hop and take. Wasn't a great pass from Marshall, of course, dropping right at his feet.
So the Bok defence is flustering Andrew Mertens just on a few occasions. And that'll be a tactic today, particularly if they've got the ball in hand too. So 10 play 6. New Zealand in the lead, having got the 2 5-pointers, but South Africa in contact. So a little collapse there, Chris. Very low, the two front rows.
Yeah, they're dropping, I think it was the hooker dropping right out of the middle. Flat in his face, not a comfortable spot to be. Troy Flavel getting some running repairs. He's obviously a bit restricted with a back spasm.
South Africa control at the back through Fox. Swanepoel, Erasmus. Little kick in behind Jonah again, but they've just handed possession back to New Zealand.
Get away, Andre!
So I think they need to forget about that tactic, because New Zealand have covered up very well. South Africa at their best when they hold onto the ball. Big kick by Montgomery. This is Mertens and Jonah. Head of steam. He's beaten three. Almost to the 10-metre line.
Advantage, advantage!
Slowed down illegally. Umanga. Erasmus, what a tackle on Tana advantage. Umanga. Referee still playing advantage here.
Come on, we're playing it.
Now we're playing on Alatini. Driving defence.
We've got an offside over here.
So slowing the ball down initially, and then he's saying there was an offside subsequently.
Number 9 killing over there, and the back's offside over here.
Nice to see some of these Springbok defenders just bouncing off Lomu. Vandenberg tries to get him down, just misses out. Then the next wave of defence emerges.
Swanepoel's the one who slows the ball down. Here he pins himself on the front of Jonah. You've got to say, unless the referee can see something, caught right in the middle of the bite.
I thought I saw an all-black hand just grab his jumper and pull him in there.
Hold him in there and call for the penalty. The Crusaders did that very successfully at Bruce Stadium in the Super 12 final. Andrew Mertens then from out in front. He's on his home patch. And he's done that many times. So 13 points to 6, a converted try, the difference. Andrew Mertens in his 43rd test.
Well, the score, they're running in New Zealand's favour here, but one area of the game that the Springboks have done well in is the kickoff.
Mertens, before this game, needing 18 points to become the heaviest point scorer in New Zealand Test rugby history. Bit of shepherding there. The referee is consistent. That one did hamper the defenders. It would have given New Zealand an advantage.
Hang on,
accidental offside.
Wait, no, there's no ball. Relax. Crouch and hold, engage.
Rock solid South African scrum. Converted try would level the scores. Van Straten and Pulsar. Percy Montgomery taken by Alatini. That's the 22 line ahead. Good work by Andre Fenter.
Don't touch it.
Kempson into scrum half. Paulson now.
See, there's no All Blacks committed to that breakdown.
Okay.
So opportunities in close.
Van Straten. Delport, the high hurdler. All Blacks try to hold him up here. Still moving forward. Once it becomes static, it's use it or lose it. Cronfield interfering. Chance here for South Africa. De Wet Barry over Umanga. Wide.
Yeah, that was just ordinary. They worked very hard at that breakdown to get the ball back from the All Black pack. And now it's just useless kick.
Collective groan from everybody outside, and I would imagine everybody in South Africa.
Probably Yaphi Mulder in particular, who's back there. The man who's been replaced by Devet Barry because of injury. Payne Randall slipped it back beautifully. Anton Oliver, 22 metre line, 13-6 New Zealand. Level again. It's bone jarring defence from the box. Here's Mertens. Space here for Umanga. Swanepoel.
He's in.
It is willing.
Well, Mertens does provide some excellent service for his outside runners out there. What's this one? He just gets a little step going and throws it wide. Umanga tries the Campese goose step. To no avail.
Well, there's no doubting the commitment of the Springbok side here today. They've come out to play Test match rugby, and the All Blacks are well aware of that. There's been some frightening defensive hits.
Well, I don't know why the game's held up, an international game, for Andre Fenner to get his contact lenses back in. Surely he's got to go off the field to do that.
They used to do it for Nick Barr-Jones. Case Mews, Tonfell did well to hold on.
No, it's not. You only have three in the end.
Quick clearance there from Marshall. Alatini. Blackadder. Carl Hoft. Justin Marshall goes in. It's just short of halfway. Grubber. Lomu. Percy. Shocking pass. Referee's whistle thankfully has gone for South Africa. But Montgomery hit the panic button again.
Again, Mertens orchestrating some excellent strategy out there. We'll grab it through this time. Defence right up on him.
Beautiful kick by Mertens. He had a look at that gap. You can't see in replay, just the referee pulling it up. Mertens is arguing with him ferociously.
Knock on there by Lomu was the ruling. New Zealand looking to take advantage of this field position. South Africa down inside their quarter. This is Mertens on this side, and Randall. Bunstra. Off he goes. Didn't need to pass it there. They've thrown it away again. Josh and Robbie Kempson.
Walk away. Walk away.
Kempson appealing to the touch judge.
Kempson's got a split over his left eye and then appeared to continue on with Josh Cromfell.
Happy Polly. Yeah, penalty here, lads. Both gentlemen.
Cromfell obviously feeling that it was maybe Kempson's boot that might have rucked him, and Kempson gets back up.
Okay. Still amazes me, Josh Confeld, the amount of contact around that breakdown. He still doesn't wear shin guard hats.
So Andrew Mertens looking for his second penalty goal. This will put him just 12 points behind Grant Fox's all-time New Zealand record. Mertens averages 15 points per test. And this is 43rd. Never in doubt. 10-point margin for New Zealand. And South Africa will look back at this first half and rue their lack of composure. When in possession, they have had some good passages of play, but it just hasn't been consistent. Ralph Thunstrat, that one's almost gathered snow. That's Troy Flavel. He's been strong in the air.
Come away, Green, come away, Green. Come away, number 16. Okay, let's have it, Justin. I want it out. Give it out, give it out, give it out. That's obstruction. That's not
his act. So, Grant, Esther Hazen's on the field. Oh, that's panic stations there from New Zealand. Montgomery's pass. Just not finding Dennis Delfort. New Zealand knocked on initially.
The Springboks not putting the All Blacks away when they cop up the ball. Something the Wallabies do very well.
Crouch and hold and engage.
Rampan,
stay on, boys, stay on.
And also Devette Barry. Is Fleck.
Get away, Black, get away, Black, get away.
Confeld the tackler. Erasmus.
No.
Great offload there.
Get away, Black, come away.
Unstrated. Barry.
Get away, Black. You've
crunching defence again from Cronfeld. Fisaki. Referee spotted an infringement. Playing advantage. Delport.
Get away, Black. Let's hands go.
Albert Vandenberg. Fiswanapool. Montgomery.
And
Fleck. Barry. And they blow it again.
We come, lads. We're killing it there.
Well, South
We're
Africa.
Here,
if they'd taken their chances in this game, could easily have been in front at this stage.
There's no doubt about that, Gordon. They, especially they go through about five phases, and that last phase just smack the ball or knock it on or take it on often.
Good transfer here. Montgomery got the ball wide and have a little go. Fleck nearly poked through the gap.
Yes, well, Troy Flavel getting a good initiation to a New Zealand Springbok test match. He's very young in terms of international experience. This is only his fourth test. This is his biggest game so far. So, vital penalty attempt here. Ram van Straten in only his eighth international. Kept his head down. 7 points the difference. We're closing on half time. We've had 2 minutes of injuries. It's still about 2 minutes to go.
10 phases at last. Line of play by the Springboks.
This is Erasmus. New Zealand steal it.
Hands in, a good advantage. Get back. He's off on the far side.
Drop goal attempt from Mertens. It's a great drop. Andrew Mertens replies for New Zealand. That's only his eighth drop goal in international rugby.
As soon as the referee called advantage, the drop goal was on. Three from the drop goal or three from the penalty, it didn't matter. Mertens just got on with the job and just his instinctive thinking snaps this one straight away. He had all the defence coming at him. It wasn't an easy kick at all. And look at that, right over the top of those big Jade Stadium posts.
Put that one down to Tane Randell, getting that ball.
19-9. 10 points the difference. Erasmus and Cricker again with a big tackle.
No, we're not on the mark.
Grant come Esther away, Hazen.
You're going to flag
penalized. It.
Hang on, boys. Oh, break up. Hold it, lads.
John Smith, actually.
Occasion Cricker into the big hit as well. Touch charge in. Cricker playing the ball. Let's listen.
Past here. Two players went past here. Number eight, Black, threw a punch at a Springbok player on the ground there.
So it's a penalty against number eight.
Yep.
For throwing a punch. And can you tell me where it is?
About 10 metres.
As he passed him.
So, Ron Cribb, that man has been penalised. Andrew Cole. You heard his judgment.
Todd,
so 16 is John Smith.
He's thrown a punch behind
new hooker on the field.
The touch judge has recommended that I penalise him over here for throwing a punch in open play. Sorry, it doesn't happen again, Todd. Thank you. It's your business. Hang on, where is it? No, don't worry about it. Where is it?
So lack of discipline could see South Africa post another three and trail by seven going in at half time.
Well, Ron Cribb, as soon as he throws his punch, he knows he's done the wrong thing. Says sorry to the referee.
Gets a got up, snuck away. Is in there nodding and saying, sorry, it's a dead giveaway.
Well, he's a protege of Wayne Shelford at North Harbour, and they didn't come any tougher than Buck Shelford.
But I don't think you'd have seen Buck saying, sorry, ref.
Well, there is Ron Cribb taking...
He gets a good one in the back of the head, doesn't he?
He does, from Rathi Erasmus.
So really, there was nothing in it, but Erasmus taken out of the play without the ball, and that was the true penalty. So Bram van Straten hasn't missed so far. 28-year-old from the Stormers. His favourite player is Naas Porter, a great goal kicker. And he's following in Naas's footsteps with a sharp shooting display here, his third penalty goal. And at half time, just 7 points separating these two giants. New Zealand 19, scoring two tries, and South Africa, all of their points coming off the boot. Three penalty goals and a drop. 19-12 at the break. Yes, well, a torrid first half of international rugby at Jade Stadium, Christchurch. New Zealand All Blacks getting the only two tries of the game to Christian Cullen. And Bram van Straten with three penalty goals and Percy Montgomery a drop. That has kept the South Africans in the game on the scoreboard, but really they've had plenty of chances to overtake New Zealand in this game. And very simply, the All Blacks have taken theirs and unfortunately the South Africans haven't. But Simon, I think the tone for the game was set very early on by a one corner cricket with that tackle on Christian Cullen.
Well, he's brought on as a defensive specialist out there. He's a hitman, and certainly Cullen, watch this, just drops him dead. And the Springboks very unlucky not to score from this. Ron Cribb across on Paulser late.
That should have been a penalty.
I think they've exploited a few of the obvious weaknesses of the Springboks. Delport is struggling on the wing. They put the ball in behind him. He really hasn't got into it. Percy Montgomery didn't want to have anything to do with it, and the All Blacks just took the advantage.
So both sides have gone into the match with that tactic of kicking behind Lomu and also Delport, but South Africa's execution has been appalling.
Yeah, well, Mertens is having a very fine game for the All Blacks and has set up most of their scoring opportunities.
So, Chris, when the South Africans held possession, did they impress you?
They did good, and I don't think they got over the advantage line quickly enough. You know, I think there's some opportunities for them in close, and they're not doing that, so that everyone's receiving the ball standing flat, and that's making it difficult to penetrate.
So, Simon, there the stats, 19-12 at half-time to New Zealand.
Well, Van Straten's had 27 possessions against 21 for Mertens, so there's been no lack of ball there for the Springboks. Referee's doing a fantastic job out there, especially playing advantage. And in the scrums, pretty even out there. Lineouts, there's been no mishaps on either side out there. But really, the scoring opportunity is taken by New Zealand.
So, yes, there is Eddie. It is at halftime, 19-12 to the All Blacks. Certainly, the men in black are in the driving seat at the moment, but the South Africans aren't going to let go of that boat. Back with more shortly. Big Norm Maxwell has come on for Troy Flavell. Flavell looked as though he was carrying some sort of injury there towards the end of that first half. And Maxwell, who played against the Wallabies last week, as the box come back onto Jade Stadium here. It's half-time, 19-12 in favour of the New Zealand All Blacks. With me in commentary, Simon Poitevin, Chris Handy.
I hope the alarm bells will be ringing in that Springbok dressing room at half-time. They're just hanging into this game. If they give any more easy opportunities out to New Zealand will punish them. And the Springboks going through a real revolution. The way they play their game out there are struggling when it comes to the final piece of execution.
Need to be better than they were against the Wallabies second half. Andre Vos
would be totally aware of that. I think the All Blacks would be disappointed they're not getting their hands on enough ball. More ball, Wayne Smith would be saying, give us the possession, wait, and the opportunities will come.
When we're ready, lads.
I think you might see Andrew Mertens maybe have a run this half. That'll create some doubt for the Springboks as well.
So Norm Maxwell is on, and the Springboks were saying in the first week of their training camp at Kooran Cove, it was so hard physically that Rassie Erasmus thought he was back in the army, and he felt very sick. So will that pay off for them now? They tape it in the second part of their campaign.
Gordon, you're saying that Bram Van Straten's famous most favourite player out there was a nice Voito. Well, I think that he's probably insomniac if that's the case, isn't he?
Just wait a second. Andre, okay now. Todd! Hang on.
Well, I know DeVette Barry is often guilty of falling asleep in the video sessions. As Bram Van Straten. No one wanted to take that on the full. But Mertens reacted well. Andre Voss. And Percy
think
Montgomery.
About it, Green, leave it. Think about it, Green.
Well, South Africa have forced a lot of turnovers from the New Zealand team today, who haven't performed as they would have liked, but they're still ahead on the scoreboard. And look at that clearance by Christian Cullen. Bouncing that one into touch.
I can't remember the last time I saw Christian Cullen kick a ball into touch. Just seems that those days are gone. We used to see test matches where that happened all the time, much to our boredom.
Five in.
So Charles Murray back on. Coming off a New Zealand hand, I think.
Knock on by Green. Knock on by Green. We come in, scrum down. You see it, lads? Knock in.
By South Africa, so good spoiling at the front.
It's the second turnover in the line-out from the Springboks. One in the first half from a short line-out. Charles Murray does struggle with the throw.
Box a little unlucky there, Blackadder tapping that ball back. Marshall. Alatini. Blackadder didn't pick it up. Charles Murray, the tackler. 10-metre line, Springbok territory. Carl Hoft. There's the trailing runner, just driving him ahead. Mertens, almost intercepted. Very dangerous pass. Corne cricket coming through. Anton Oliver. Crick has been fantastic in defence for the Springboks. Mark Robinson making sure he didn't go near that touchline. Case Mews.
There's no advantage here. Wrong side of the tackle, scrum half. Here it is, on this man here.
Chris White again.
Nine, discipline.
Good advantage, and it was number nine. Bernard Swanepoel who provided that penalty as the South African bench looks on.
Grant Esterhazen closest. And Chester Williams. Chester Williams, a very creative player. Hopefully he'll be seen in the second half.
It was only a momentary lapse there by Swanepoel.
Well, he just didn't return, did he? He came pulled out of the situation on the ground and I think was right in front. But the All Blacks just steadied in Sydney last week, just at the start of the second half, and that set up the opportunity to win it.
Well, this will take some of the stuffing out of South Africa's cause. Mertens has found the groove. 22-12. So Andrew Mertens gets his third penalty goal. Now 9 points behind Grant Fox's all-time record. Set back for the box. Good restart from Van Straten. Andre Venter, Voss, Erasmus, this is Van Straten.
Sure
good tackle by Confeld on Fleck.
There it is.
DeVette Barry. Oh, he's lost it again. He's done that twice. Ron Cribb.
There it comes, let go, Green.
Alatini, just drifting across field. They're holding possession here. Swanepoel offside.
His legs away, this man.
And the referee right on the spot there.
On the floor, move away.
Front strike and the man penalised.
Cronfeld's having a huge influence in this game, pressuring the Springboks when they're trying to clear the ball, but also in defence and at the breakdown, he's been everywhere.
But it was significant last week when Cronfeld came on the field that the All Blacks steadied and eventually finished on top at Stadium Australia.
I'll tell you what, hang on, but Alvin Funderburg, he must have needed eyes in the back of his legs to see that ball there. Bit tough.
Greens open up in the middle.
South Africa have been penalised 6 times at the ruck and ball.
South Africa get it again. The Achilles heel from New Zealand, the line out. Robbie Fleck. All the forwards out here in midfield. Over Jonah's head. Christian Cullen. Not too many chases there for South Africa. But, they've cleaned up well. 22 metre line. Umanga.
Come on, it went back. It went back.
Went backwards, said the referee.
Your lad knocked it there.
Andre Benter coming through.
Get up and go, get up and go.
And Mertens.
Get up and go.
Thumped. Erasmus. Former Springbok skipper. Fleck. Nice step.
Get away, Black.
Blackadder in defence. Tulsa. Montgomery. Umanga. And the All Blacks, I think, took that into touch. So that was actually a good decision by South Africa to let the ball go there, not try and pick it up. And it forced New Zealand to take the ball into touch.
Well, we haven't seen enough of Montgomery hitting this Springbok back line, and he has got exceptional skill. He's very evasive. Mertens gets past him and then lays the ball back.
You take on Mertens every time in that situation. You just see that lack of strength in the upper body of Mertens in that situation. That's what the Wallabies try and exploit. Each time in around short with Kefu punching up.
Well, I don't think Mertens has been successful in a tackle in two test matches to date.
Well, David Wilson exploited it very well last week, winning the ball back the line out there. The first man he saw was Mertens, and he just went straight for him.
Stay there, Alan.
So this is the box chance to get back into it. Boss. Now they roll it. Swanepoel. Oh, the pass couldn't find Pulsa. Another line out for South Africa. And that's been the problem, the finish for the Springboks.
And if you ever wanted a player in your pocket, that'd be Tulsa. Look at him, he's just trying to get in there. The task bounces off Josh Cronfeld.
So Foss in the middle, Andre Benter at the front. Up the back we go. Foss. Good clean out.
In the side.
Professional foul by New Zealand.
Well, in the side, but also you'd have to think he's been pulled down as he tried to move through there. Just got slammed to the ground.
Well, if he was, the penalty comes in a bit further. Now it's decision time for the Springboks. They've got to score here. This is makes or breaks their game. And I think it's a pretty good option. Their line-out's working well. It must work better now. Murray. Got to be spot on, and they've got to know what's on.
Well, Fenter's their money man in this line out.
New Zealand will contest here. Norm Maxwell up at the back. Ron Cribb just surveying, trying to work out where this one's going. Andre Fenter.
There it is, boys. Let it go.
Did so well. Norm Maxwell just hovering at the back here. Very close.
No.
Well, they have spoiled themselves. The referee said there was a man in front being used as a shield.
That's what I told him. The first man down.
That's what racking's all about when you're in contact.
John asked me about that.
That's what that maul's all about. I don't know where the ball was in all of it.
No penalties, boys.
Kobus Fazaki's the instructor. You're the referee. Mertens is looking to clear this one.
Well, that's been the story of the day for South Africa. Charge down.
Let's give it, lads.
score.
They're certainly applying the blowtorch here, the men in green. Brosnahan.
Green's come away, lads.
The Blacks are able to break out from here. It'll be a cruel and almost irrecoverable blow. Must maintain it.
Take it out. Come here. Come with me. Okay, I'll do it.
Exactly the same thing to us.
They had the ball.
It has been working both ways.
Are you injured?
I was
yeah, no, he came across. The penalty's here. I don't want to see it happen again. Are you okay to carry on? Yeah.
Well, the danger was that it could have been a sin bin, and I think that's why Andre Voss was getting agitated. The referee, I think, was contemplating a yellow card, but some swift talking there. Persuasive talking by Andre Voss.
Well, persuasive talking from Basaki as well, saying it was an injury which sort of forced him down.
Yeah. And pigs fly.
Dangerous play there by Basaki. Case Mews off. Craig Dowd on for New Zealand.
Well, Craig Dowd now becomes the most capped All Black front rower.
Yes, tying Olo Brown with 56.
Okay.
He's also played a couple of tests in the second row. Craig Dowd. Mertens, Alatini.
Push it back, there it is.
Cronfeld. De Vet Barry didn't put him to ground.
No, leave it green, leave it.
New Zealand just looking for some space here. Tulsa and Montgomery. Went so close to the touchline, and that one off the side of his boot. His body language told you what happened to that kick.
Percy had done all the hard work keeping himself in field there, then he's got a prodigious boot, just couldn't utilise it.
South Africa has vowed to contest every New Zealand throw, and if ever they need one, this is it.
Second half, Oliver and the line-out lost possession in this sort of position last week.
Out into midfield for Robinson.
Get away, Green! Get away, there it is!
Two centres taken out. Anton Oliver.
Get away, Green, there it is! Back foot! Stay back!
Cullen. Two tries get to away, his Green. Name today. We're just outside the 22. Marshall now.
Leave it, Green! That's good.
Lost by New Zealand. Tulsa. That's very clever play by Brayton Tulsar. Look at the speed. He only has to force it. Cullen first. They've done it again, New Zealand at the death.
Well, the All Blacks can't complain about the Springboks forcing the air at the breakdown. They've been doing it all game to the Springboks. This time they turn it round. Tulsar. What about the chase from Christian Cullen?
Well, he hit the ground that time nearly as hard as he did previous in the first tackle.
But it was a gallant effort by Brayton Tulsar, and that's a magnificent dropout. South Africa back inside their quarter. Bram van Straten unleashes. Oh, that's a huge kick. Almost down to the goal line. Chance for a counter. Cullen. Driven back in the tackle. Ron Cribb dives straight in. Lefty speak.
Leave it alone, you two. He's on his own. The support's gone straight over.
Well, it's deep breaths all round at the moment, Chris Handy.
Let's go, gentlemen.
But South Africa, really with an opportunity here to apply some pressure on New Zealand.
It was differently to the first Tri Nations game. The ball's being kicked to either end of the field when it was run last week, but it is very effective. Tulsar getting into space, beautifully put that ball in front. Cullen's, you know, what a great fullback he is when you need him most.
Yes, just the speed of the man. He's playing his 46th test match in a row. So he's never been dropped from the New Zealand team. and the record for consecutive test matches is 53, belonging to Gareth Edwards.
And wasn't a good kick from Van Straten to put that ball back down on the All Black 25, as we see Troy Flavelle looking on to force the penalty.
First penalty attempt of the second half for Van Straten. And he's pulled that one. John Smith there in the foreground. Chester Williams, the experienced hand.
I think the boys know just how important that penalty would have been. Look at the face on Nick Mallett. Tells the story.
Yes, the Springboks just not getting the reward for all of that endeavour. Vandenberg picking up the rebound. Chance to go again. This is Fleck, Montgomery and Tulsa. Tulsa was tackled there without the ball. Alatini.
Get away, Green. Get away. Get off him, Green. Number one.
Swanepoel attacker. 22-12 New Zealand. Just the penalty goal in the second half. Tane Randall. Good ball security from him on halfway.
He's killing it on the floor.
There's another penalty offence here. Mark Robinson.
You've got your hand on the ball. Get it off quicker, please. You.
And it looks as though Swanepoel has handled the ball on the ground, slowing it down.
Well, that's number three for Werner Swanepoel, possibly four.
Hardly been anybody else penalised. The Springbok side. And, he says that he plays around with it on the ground. The referee, everything scrambles.
Terrific work rate by Andre Fenter. That's Noel Maxwell.
Okay.
Blackadder. Okay. Oliver. Met by Charles Murray. Chance to move it into space. Jonah. It's taken four men away, there to stop him. That's also taken men out of the defensive line. Just three out there on the left. Jonah again. Straight through Kobus Basaki.
Get up, get up, get up!
Cronfeld and Muse. Lost ahead. A little bit of decoy obstruction running also from New Zealand.
Interesting, Mark Robinson. He really hasn't made the impression that Eremia did last week against the Wallabies. Eremia created a lot of gaps through passing the ball. Look at Lohu. Fakes the punch.
And hold and engage.
So the box are treading water at the moment. They're just keeping their heads above the surface. But the dam could burst very soon if they don't get some points on the board.
Down. Wait. Wait. Rolling down on top. Penalty against.
Can't agree with that. All Black scrum clearly stronger. The first contact. They should have got the penalty for not putting the ball in, and now turned it back to the Springboks.
So, 10 points the difference at Jade Stadium. Wins the ball from their line-out throw.
I've got him, he's using his feet.
This is Fleck, he's been well contained in midfield by Alatini. Van Straten.
Referee playing advantage.
We come back here. He's killing it here now, that's not going to be an advantage. Number one is killing it with his foot.
So a chance to take play deep into New Zealand territory.
This rather parochial Canterbury crowd, unimpressed with referee Chris White, but he saw Carl Hoff trying to slow the ball with his feet.
Okay, Andre.
Started. Nice flowing punt, taking it down to the 22. And defender there, Craig Dowd. Albert Vandenberg at the back here is the money man.
Hunstrut straightens up.
Let it come, let it come.
Andre Fenta almost got through. Vandenberg, South Africa, needs the five-pointer. Another infringement from the Blacks, but the Boks need the try. Brosnahan tackled by Mertens. Swanepoel to Purvis Fisaki. Montgomery, Robbie Fleck, knocked back. Thought that one was lost back, but the referee saw it differently.
There,
I'm not quite sure of that advantage by Chris White. And it's about time, I think he starts to search for that yellow card.
Hang on, boys.
Professional fouls going on all over the place.
Six phases there from the Springboks.
Stay on, boys, stay on.
Andrew Mertens,
let's go, let's go.
Drilling it into touch, just 35 metres out from his goal line.
Well, just as there's been good use of the advantage law, I think, Chris White, there's a poor interpretation there. You can't get advantage going across and back in the field, you know. And just felt the Springboks desperately needed that penalty to get the ship rolling on again.
Away,
Albert Vandenberg, good
stay
reaction. Josh Kronfeld sneaking up offside.
Get away, Ben. Get off it.
Swanepoel. Montgomery. Craig Dowd.
Get away, Ben. Get away.
Just managed to hold on. Pulsar. Nasty bounce. Cullen. Blackadder was there.
Let it come. Let it come. Stay back for it. That's good.
Great work
stay
there by the All Black skipper. Almost charged down by Vandenberg. Montgomery somehow held on. Well, he kicked a 45-metre drop goal. And here's Jonah. This could be the ultimate punishment. Van Straten put his body on the line.
Tell you what, if I was Nick Mallett now or Alan Solomons, I'd get him off. That's just ludicrous.
Yank him. Montgomery, what a shocking option. Now he puts it to the others, and look, Van Straten just puts the body on the line, just about ends up with a dislocated jaw. He gets a pat on the head from Jonah to say not a bad attempt.
Tennis Delport okay, should go to fullback, and Chester Williams should come onto the wing.
Get away, Greens, get away, Greens, let go.
This is Cripp. Fantastic defence again from Fornay Cricker. Driven New Zealand back 5 metres. And the errors are coming from the men in black. They just seem to be sitting on this lead at the moment. And South Africa just keep coming at them.
You have to see Mertens run the ball. He's passed on 22 occasions, kicked on 12.
No penalties in the air, lads. Hang on, count them in.
Van Straten has run on 7 occasions.
Three, four, one, that's it.
He's
just
come up.
Justin, go back.
23 minutes gone in this second half. Maxwell has stolen the throw by Moraine. So both sides having their problems in the lineouts. Alatini. Lined up by Van Straten. Kronfeld.
No.
Andre Fenta really standing his ground.
There it is. Let go, Green.
It's been
I am moving.
Wonderful conviction from the South African defence in particular, but they've committed a foul.
You've got a penalty. You've just done over there. Do you want me to send it off?
Second time Albert Vandenberg's been penalised for interfering with the ball with his feet. The first time he wasn't guilty. Difficult there.
The line-out's turning into a bit of a nightmare there for the Springboks. They've lost three to the All Blacks. And Norm Maxwell's got two of them.
But you can see Van Straten also slowing the ball down there once the ruck had formed. Tane Randall.
Hurts right out in the centre of the field. That's Robinson.
Here come, no green, that's good.
Attacking the advantage line there was Case Mews. Finally, the All Blacks get some go forward from their pack. Cullen. They're tackling for keeps, South Africa.
Yes.
Cullen didn't release.
Easy. No, calm down. He's hanging on, lads. Move away, there's no support.
And the referee was still talking to the players, so right back.
Slow it down, boys.
It's a rather impossible instruction to tell Josh Contos to calm down.
I haven't given a mark yet.
Any time he's on a rugby field, he's on fire.
The referee's saying, I hadn't given the mark, so you didn't take it from the right spot.
It's push back, lads. Push back.
So Montgomery to the 10-metre line, New Zealand territory. Still 10 points the difference. It's a war of attrition at the moment.
Three green. One land them off. Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you're okay.
Billy Mayer from the Cats is on. And number 17 at the back of the lineouts. Man who was in great form. And again, stolen ball. This is Venter. And there was a little knock on.
Unlucky, boys.
Springboks have got to have a better throw than Shaw Murray.
They exposed it in Melbourne and the same thing here. Desperately disappointed, I'm sure, Voss would be.
Holding cracks. No.
Good contesting by the Blacks.
You've got new people in there. Stay still, there's your mark. Don't move. Oh, there's no second rows. Holding cracks.
So Billy Mayer at tight head prop. Springbok.
No, I don't like it, lads. I don't like it. We've got new blokes on. We're starting out. No problem so far. I want it steadier with that armour. Outside point. Right there, it's your mark. Hold and crouch and engage.
So referee Chris White, a very perky character. Lost by Cribb. Pinched here by Cricker. Sloppy work by New Zealand at the back of that scrum. Chance South Africa. Fleck.
Get away, Blacks, get away.
It's been pinched. It was a ruck.
Let it go green.
Craig down.
Mertens. Well, that's a real heartbreaker.
Get away, Green. Get away now. Let it come.
Umanga.
Get away, number 8. Get away. Stay here, boys. Stay here. Offside that, number 19.
I heard the referee telling South Africa they were offside. He's going to pull it back for the penalty.
It's number 19. He's lazy there. He's not going back. He's affecting number 19.
Well, South Africa has done more than enough to win this game, but they find themselves 10 points down on the scoreboard through their lack of finishing power.
It's the one-off runners which are really making life tough for the Springboks, leading to the turnovers.
Halfway line, 10 points the difference. Now is Tony Brown for his 12th test match. He made his debut against the Samoans in 1999, and Andrew Mertens leaves his home turf. So still he's short of that Grant Fox record. Todd Blackadder.
Come away, Greens!
Ron Cribb.
Get away, Green! Get off it!
Now this is about the stage where South Africa really tired against Australia.
Get away, Green! Stay there, Green, back foot.
Brown, straight up. A silly play there by Cornet Cricker. This is a yellow card.
You look for him, you hit him, and you hurt him.
So that's just a lack of discipline. Cornet Cricker shouldering the man out of the way, off the ball.
Well, most of your chances go down the gurgler when you're one man short at any stage. And the referee summed it up very succinctly.
22-12, New Zealand. Valentini recovers. The Springboks a man down. And we have about 11 and a half minutes to go. And that's a disaster because they will only have Cricker back for the last minute or so.
And Crick has had a very fine game for the Springboks, but on that occasion, so clearly just takes out Alatini.
Good time, Colin. Good time.
Well, South Africa's defence has been the feature of their game here today. But one of their most effective tacklers is in the sin bin. And this will just about put New Zealand out of touch. 25-12. It means that the South Africans would have to score two tries and convert both. Tony Brown, no nonsense, 25-12, 13 points the difference.
Tony Brown on for Mertens. Mertens, at the time he was on the field, had 36 possessions. He passed on 24 occasions and kicked on 12.
They got away!
So another good restart by Van Straten. Todd Blackadder.
There it is, there it is, there it is. Let it go.
The tuck get going. Brayton Paulser and Montgomery again. He was looking for the touch but didn't get it. His team didn't need that. Rob Cripp. Brosnahan the tackler. Marshall. Tony Brown. Maxwell arrives. Lost a head there by Brown.
Knocked on, easy on, easy, flat, move out.
Well, a man down the box. Need nothing short of a miracle now to win this game.
Scrum going to be at risk with that man down.
Hang on, lad. There's no second row. No, it's tiptoes. Hold and crouch and engage.
John Smith, the hooker packing at loose head prop, and they're driven backwards. Andre Voss. Swanepoel.
Sorry.
Van Straat. Barry. Maxwell.
Get away, Green, get away.
That's Case Muse. That's the 22 metre line ahead. Here go the Blacks. Tana Rimanga has the legs. A metre and a half out from the goal line.
Absolutely open territory there. Good option. Maxwell's made a real big impact since coming on. Alatini gets the ball through.
Wait!
Jeffrey has a look at his clock.
Yes, Andre.
It tells him there's allowing for injuries, 8 minutes to go.
A bit of pressure on this Murray throw. Needs to be spot on.
You've been in and out, lads. It's three again. Sir, chew it. Your scrum half. Okay, go on then. Free kick numbers.
So numbers there for South Africa. New Zealand, that's a cardinal sin. Brosnahan. Referee's happy with that. Alatini.
Get away, Green.
Trouble. Jonah. Delport. South Africa got in between him and the support player. They're back in possession. Hanging on by the skin of their teeth. Bobby Fleck. Lapa Skupny's on the field. South Africa still breathing.
The impact of the breakdown from both sides, the clean out, it's just full on.
Josh Kronfeld on all fours. 25-12. Andre Penter has had a change of shorts. He's given a mammoth performance here today, playing his first full test as a lock.
Substitute.
they certainly have hurt New Zealand in defence.
Robertson on for Cronfeld. Good change.
Very effective player today, Josh Cronfeld. Penta got it. That's Lovis Gutney, who plays with the Cats.
I am.
And just the structure of South Africa's attack has really been scatty. Here's Brad Stratton. Just couldn't offload there to Fenta. Good tackle by Umanga. That's Billy Mayer.
Here it comes.
They're over the halfway line.
Sorry.
Andre Fox. We've
got offside out wide here. Captain!
Oh, is this going to be a yellow card?
Please. Yes, please. As the game gets towards the end, we've had two or three offsides now. Somebody could disappear, all right? It was one of your players. It's a call out there. It's a team one. Two green subs, lads.
It's been subtly going on the whole game.
At the line out. Okay.
Well, this is... been a very courageous performance by the South Africans. Their execution hasn't been there, but they just refuse to lie down. Joost van der Westhuizen now, the test record holder for the box. Can he inspire some magic in the dying stages? Five and a half minutes left on the clock. Voss. Mayer. Back through his legs. Van Straten, Barry, just running into a brick wall.
Get away, Black, get
Tony
away.
Brown, the tackler.
Away, Black, get away!
And the Bulldogs, very tight in defence, close to the ruck. Todd Blackadder, driving
get away,
back.
Get away, there it is.
He's opposite skipper.
Stay back foot, gentlemen. Stay, no, it's not yet. No.
Box need a converted try. It's their only hope for the last gasp victory. Tony Brown in the tackle. Lost ahead by New Zealand.
Come forward off Black there, into another Black. Into
that's
another
a good black decision.
Down here.
Well, the Springboks making no impression on the advantage line. Brown leading the defence up and just steals the ball here, very legally. It sets it back, and then the mistake comes.
Actually, that's quite illegal, playing it on the ground. Should have been a penalty to the box. So here's to Barry. Pulses with him. Still going. Remember, South Africa is a man down. Billy Mayer.
Don't touch it.
He's like a block of granite. Oh, Lovis Gutney. Going nowhere. Quick ball. Andre Fenta. Rugged defence now from New Zealand as they dig in.
Let go, Blacks. Let go. No, it's tackle ball there. It's going that way. It's scrum down, Blacks.
That's the end for South Africa. Any faint hope they had.
Crucial turnover. And you've got to give it to the All Blacks today. They battered and bruised, not only physically but also mentally, from last week's encounter with the Wallabies, and they've hung in there. It hasn't been flash in the second half, but defence has been great, and they've just snuffed out any Springbok initiatives. They've really put it to the Springbok and said, well, come on, come up with something and we'll counter it.
Let's go, boys.
Marshall got his kick away. That sums up Percy's afternoon. Well, Nick Mallett has huge faith in this guy. But I think a lot of people are surprised that he's still out there.
Here's the mistake, but hasn't Norm Maxwell made an impact since hitting the field?
Mr. Fears also that the Chester Williams is the only one on the South African bench that hasn't been used.
Come away.
We are huge number of turnovers this game. 26 to South Africa, 19.
Crouch and hold.
No lock. The All Blacks.
Crouch and hold and engage.
Tane Randall cleared. Just a couple of minutes remaining. New Zealand.
If we get tackle ball scrum down.
Will be unbeaten. South Africa, if they can get a converted try in the closing stages, would at least get a bonus point.
Well, the bookies were giving 13 and a half start to South Africa. There's some nervous punters out there.
Well, the last try scored by Cullen was in the 15th minute of the first half, and it's defences on top since then.
Coming in very late. Yeah. So
cricket quicker. Should be back on the field any moment.
Yeah. Concentration, lads. It's get a second row. No, it's no second rows. Crouch and hold and engage.
This has been like a good old-fashioned test match between these two countries. Referee got in the way and interfered. I think even let out a little expletive.
Same scrimmage. I took him out. Their ball. Yeah. Sorry, mate. Hang on, lads. Square, lads. Crouch and hold. English. Good.
Tony Brown. Alatini got a big gap. Cullen couldn't hold on. Counters on here for South Africa.
Bring it.
Sister Vet Barry. Rubber Scutney. Mercifully, the referee lets it go on. Tulsa. Brown punch start.
It's your pass. Get out of the way. Get out of the way, Black.
So bonus point is the issue now for South Africa. Converted try will give them a bonus point. They can't win the game. Just over halfway.
It's off your own player.
Montgomery.
Let go, Black. Play up.
Off New Zealand, charge down. But they've just run out of ideas and attack South Africa. Hunstrat. New Zealand too well organised, close to the ruck. Now you've got Big Locks chipping through. And Big Jonah saying thank you. Well, he's taken about six South Africans out of the play. Crip. But these men in green just keep forcing errors and throwing themselves into the fray. They go down fighting. New Zealand unbeaten after two matches in Tri Nations. Gee, that was a tough one, says Todd Blackadder. 25-12. A couple of opportunist tries in the first half, proving the difference between these two teams. They really did play themselves to a standstill at Jade Stadium. All Blacks 25, Springboks 12. Well, it was crunching, grueling, torrid, a traditional test match between the old foes, New Zealand and South Africa. Just those two tries to Cullen in the first 15 minutes, final score 25-12. Let's have a look at the stats now with Simon Poitevin.
Well, interesting, the penalties. Referee actually did a good job out there, and there are very few for a Northern Hemisphere referee. The line-outs are not mere for South Africa. Five turnovers to the All Blacks. Turnovers in total, 24 to South Africa, 19. The All Blacks were too many. And really, the All Blacks used their possession very well.
OK, let's now hear from the winning skipper. His home ground in Canterbury. And we'll hear from Todd Blackadder in a few moments. Chris Handy, just before we go to Todd, what was the difference?
I think the difference was, it's one thing to say you're going to play an open game and the other thing is to carry it out. And the Springboks clearly couldn't carry it out. They still had difficulty with their line out at crucial stages, and you don't do that against the All Blacks. The All Blacks had a tough physical week, but they were able to hang out.
Yes, well, Todd Blackadder is ready for us now, and I'd say he's a pretty proud guy at the moment. Let's go back to Jade.
Toddy, your face says it all. That's very, very tough going.
Yeah, it's been a tough week, you know, and it certainly was a tough game out here today. And, you know, both teams really fired, and the Springboks really took it to us, and, it, you know, it was a great physical game.
In the end, perhaps that D word again, defence, that we see so often down here at Jade Stadium, this time in the black jersey, that was the key.
Yeah, you got to have good D no matter who you're playing against. You know, we really got exposed a couple of times, and, you know, the guys really stuck to their guns, and we come out, we knew we were going to have to really D up around those rucks because the Springboks were just making too many yards, and, you know, our guys certainly D'd up, put some big hits on in the end, so it certainly improved.
After last week, people will say it wasn't the same spectacle, it perhaps was never going to be. It was much more physical, a lot more errors.
Yeah, a lot more errors. You know, that's to do with pressure, and, you know, it was probably, last week was a lot faster and pretty physical, but today, you know, both sides really just sort of hammered away at each other, and probably typical of a Springbok New Zealand game.
Short break for.
Yes, well, a lot of mistakes in the game, a lot of turnovers. I think it was 24-19 in that regard, so that really gives you an idea how strong the defence was as well. Let's hear from the Springbok skipper now, Andre Vos.
Well, Andre, All Black Springbok test, always tough. That was one of the top ones.
Oh, certainly very tough. Like what I asked, that number's given. Like I said, really typically an All Black South Africa game, and we enjoyed every minute. Got to give credit to the All Blacks, their defence is outstanding, and they deserved the win on the day.
You tried to play the ball in hand time of rugby, you tried to run at them often. It was just the finishing that let you down at times.
Yeah, some of the handling in the first half particularly let us down a lot. Balls knocked on, you're just turning the ball over and giving them the ball, it's as simple as that. So very disappointing from that point of view, but in the second half came together quite nicely. We put quite a bit of pressure down on their line, but like I said, credit to them, they defended outstandingly.
Your scrum seemed to go very well, but you had a few line-out problems in the second half.
Yeah, it's not something that's going particularly well for us at the moment. We struggled against Australia, and All Blacks obviously saw that and worked our stuff out to compete against us. So we're just really going to have to go back and work from scratch, I think, for those.
Yeah, Australia next week. At least you can head back over there with your heads held high. Much better performance, eh?
Thanks very much.
Yes, and there's the Tri Nations table. New Zealand, two wins from two, also a bonus point. South Africa without any points, and they face Australia now at Stadium Australia next Saturday night. And what a game that will be. There are still plenty of good seats available, so get along, Gold Rush, support the Wallabies in their big one against South Africa. Simon, you must be looking forward to that clash.
Yeah, that'll be a really good game out there at Stadium Australia, and the Australians keen to get that momentum going for that August the 5th game in New Zealand. So in attack in particular, I think it's a dynamic side next weekend.
The physicalness has come back into Springbok rugby, Chris.
Yeah, it has, Gordon. Maybe not so much of the subtlety, but I think for the person out there, for the watcher, the last two games at Stadium Australia have just been superb wins for the Wallabies. You have to be there to see it. I'm looking forward to it.
Yes, we will be there in force on the Seven Network. Join us for more great Tri Nations action. Stadium Australia, the Wallabies and the Springboks. Don't miss it here on Seven. We'll see you then.